Today on BRStv, we're taking a closer look at controllable AC pumps. Hi, I'm RT, one of your hosts of BRStv, and today we're doing a quick product spotlight on the latest line of pumps from Italy, the AC-powered Rossmont movers and their controller, the Waver. We'll cover what makes these pumps unique, answer a few of your questions, hit on some features and tips, and finish with a quick install. The Rossmont Waver pumps are unique in the fact that they're entirely AC powered, but also can be connected to the Waver controller for some pretty advanced control features. Prior to this, AC pumps in general were only able to be controlled by simple on-off programming via an aquarium controller or a simple timer. To start off with just the mover pumps, it offers a cheaper starting cost as you get your feet wet with these power heads. Then, if you decide you want to add controllability to your power heads later, you can do so by simply purchasing the Waver controller and connecting the pumps to it. In most other cases, if you start out with non-controllable pumps, you need to buy a brand new power head setup to add controllability. Plus, using AC power does away with any power bricks or power supplies that take up valuable real estate in your stand. Instead, there's just simply a power cord and a plug. When we initially posted a photo of these pumps to our Instagram page, we got a few questions relating to the amount of noise these pumps put out. The mounts on the pumps themselves have what Rossmont refers to as their VAS technology, or their vibration absorbing system. Frankly, it's essentially just five soft rubber O-rings, one on the dry mount, one on each side of the wet mount, one on the ball mount, and one on the pump itself. That being said, it does a surprisingly good job of keeping the pump quiet. We hooked up a mover M1900 to this test tank here and ran our decibel meter near it. It's pretty comparable to other pumps out there that I would consider on the quieter spectrum like Corralia, Tunzi's DC pumps, and the CJ Extremes. Moving over to the Waver, it's Wi-Fi enabled and allows you to control your pumps from your favorite device through its browser. That means that while you're on vacation or you're at work, you can make changes to your flow from your smartphone or your laptop. Its two channels can adjust your pumps from 30% to 100% of their total flow with six different presets like fixed, fish food, off, cycle, random, and stormy. I've seen these things make a pretty impressive standing wave before. We decided to install two movers and a waver on our clown harem tank. To start, I'll need to clean the inside of the tank where I plan on putting the pumps in order to ensure the mount is able to securely grip the panel. And then I'm going to clip them into their mounts. Then I'll mount the pumps where I think they offer the best pattern of flow. You could potentially use the included flow concentrator to narrow the stream, but I prefer a wider flow, so I'll use the pumps without it. We do have a large amount of smaller fish in this tank though, so we'll be using the included protective grid. Installing the waver is pretty simple. In short, you plug it in, the controller runs a self-check during which the LEDs in the case will pulse three times. Once the white LED is stable, connect to the waver's Wi-Fi signal using your device and enter this IP address. Finally, log in using the username Rossmont and the password waver. Once you're in, you can add or remove pumps, select from various presets, and make changes to your tank's flow. As you can see, the pumps can create some pretty impressive random movement your corals will appreciate. Final few quick tips, the impeller on this pump is pretty cool and it's unlike anything I've personally seen before. The impeller is designed to lock in place using this unique locking mechanism. The best part about this is that you don't need to try to line the shaft up with the bearings like some other pumps. This just naturally fits into place. Thanks for watching. If you liked what you saw and you want to be sure to see more great content, give us a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe. See you Friday with the next episode of 52 FAQ.